Hello and welcome to the Cabinet of Doll Curios, where you will find creations of horror, beauty and the perfectly imperfect. I started off by making an armature for my clown out of wire and then I wrapped it with aluminium foil. That way you end up using a lot less clay. I'm just applying Super Sculpey to make up the face and the details. You don't have to wear gloves while using Super Sculpey. I just wanted to eliminate fingerprints without having to go over it with a clay softener at the end and miss some probably. I just love the character of my Grimaldi the Clown wall bust that I decided to do a full body version of him. I'm just inserting some glass cabochon eyes and the pattern that is behind them is what I did on my home computer. Designed some eyes and printed them out and stuck them on the back with clear glue. I find to get more organic lines, if you use cling film between the clay and your tools, you'll find it gives a lovely, less sharp of an edge or cut mark. Give it a try yourself, experiment. I'm just wrapping the limbs with some leftover material, just so it's you can't feel the foil underneath the clothes. There's no pattern for these clothes. Again, I winged it. But a bit later on, you'll find that I actually cut the arms off because I think it's a little bit too baggy and I wanted the arms more of a close fitting just to give that extra little bit of design detail. I'm using epoxy sculpt here, so of course gloves are to be worn with this. I'm using epoxy sculpt because I wanted it to be heavy on the feet to help the doll stand up. Although it still would have stood up if I'd have continued to use super Sculpey, I just thought because epoxy sculpt is heavier, it would be a little bit better to use. Almost like a bit of an anchor, if you will. Here's my 3mm grommeton washers to do the eyelets for the boots. I'm actually using Worbla here, which you heat up with a hairdryer to form the shoes, or the boots rather. So the boots are made up of Worbla, fake leather, and the metal eyelets for the laces. I'm going in now with some Panpastels to give the clown its detail. In between each finished layer, I spray with Mr. Super Clear to help protect the work. Thank you. Now I'm just going in with a very watered down black just to give the outfit some more dimension, some dirt, grime, history. And I'll scuff the boots a little bit as well. And as I did with my Grimaldi the Clown bust feature, I'm actually doing the same sort of neck piece using watered down blue paint. Now I'm just scraping off the excess paint from the glass cabochon eyes. Don't worry, this doesn't damage it. Now I'm just going in with gloss over the eyes, lips, and making the shoes look glossy too. For the hair, I use this super chunky wool and then just separating the strands using tacky glue to glue it on with. I didn't fill the top of his head with Sculpey clay as I didn't know how I was going to fasten the hat. I might have used a screw, I may have used a metal rod. As it turns out, super glue fixed it perfectly and it covered the hole anyway. And I've called this clown Zagan. The name Zagan can mean demon king and who is deceitful. And here he is.